हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर पवन शिवनकर एंड आई वेलकम यू इन अ फर्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ मैकेनिक्स ऑफ मटेरियल। एंड यू कैन सी दिस इज़ अ यूटीएम मशीन, यूनिवर्सल टेस्टिंग मशीन, ओवर विच विल परफॉर्म टेंसाइल टेस्ट, कॉम्प्रेशन टेस्ट एंड शीयर टेस्ट। सो दिस इज़ अ कंट्रोल यूनिट एंड दिस इज़ अ सॉफ्टवेयर फॉर यूटीएम ओवर विच वी कैन सी डिफरेंट रीडिंग्स। सो जनरली थ्री पैरामीटर वी कैन सी हियर, लोड एंड extension, two parameters. So as we are applying a load gradually on the specimen, so accordingly extension we will get. So three different practicals will be conducted on the same machine: tension test, then compression test and shear test. Okay students, so we are conducting first test on a mild steel, and here you can see the specimen. This is of mild steel, 4 centimeter, that is 40 mm diameter and 8 centimeter length. Start kar. So you can see the value of load is increasing. It is still 197.7 and the displacement is 0.5. Actually no displacement is here, but the value of load is increasing. Right now it is 221 kilonewton. So load will be in a kilonewton and the displacement will be in mm. You can see specimen is compressing. Now we will take out this specimen and we'll check whether it is compressed or by what amount, which amount it is compressed. Now we'll check whether if the current diameter is increased by some amount, that means it is compressed. It seems to be a 42 mm,
Before compression it is a 40 mm, and now after compression test it is 42 or mm around. And
deformation zala na, lean kami zali, lean 80 cm hoti tar 76 zali, 75.
And as far as length is concerned, so length is decreased by around 4 mm. It was 80 mm before compression test and now it is 76 mm. Okay, and we have another specimen like aluminium. It is very soft material as compared to mild steel, so we will get a better result as compared to mild steel. Now students, we are using a second specimen which is of aluminium and performing the same test, that is a compression test. Okay, so dimensions are same of that specimen. A diameter is 40 mm and length is 80 mm, but the material is different. Previously we have used mild steel and now we are using aluminium. Okay, so let us go for test. Here you can see load is increasing. Right now the value is 427 kN and displacement is 3.64. You can see here a graph which is indicated in a yellow line. It shows value of load and accordingly value of displacement. Here you can see it is compressing. Shape is deforming. We have stopped applying load and now we will check the values, sorry, the shape of this specimen. Considerably the dimensions are changed. You can see here the diameter is increased by some amount and it get oval shape at middle edge vernier. Now we will check diameter of this specimen and it is around 41 mm. Previously it was 40 mm and length should get decreased and the length is 63 mm. Previously it was 60 mm, now it is 63 mm. Okay, so this specimen get compressed. And lastly we will test on brass material. So this is a specimen that we are going to check. The dimension of specimen is, it is 25 mm in a diameter and 51 mm in length. So we have placed our specimen. It is locked now. Now gradually we are increasing our load.
So here you can see it is again a compressing. Actually same test we are performing. We have done test on the mild steel, then aluminium, and now the test is performing on brass material. Okay, so same results we will get here. Again dimension, diameter of brass material, that is the diameter of brass material will get increased and length will get decreased. Okay, so here our observation report is finished, then we will go for the calculation. Okay. Thank you. So guys, we have done test on the brass material and we got the result. Like this specimen get crushed like in oval shape. You can see here it get converted into or split it into two pieces. That means this is a kind of a brittle material. It is not get compressed, it is crushed into two pieces. Okay, so these are the results for our compression test. Thank you. And the